Hello, everyone. We're going to be checking out the Steam Games Awards 2022. Now, Steam Games and the awards are not the be-all, end-all of Game Awards, but nonetheless, definitely is worth a laugh. So, Game of the Year, Elden Ring, we all saw that coming. Looking back at 2022, you might even say that this was the only high production, good quality game there was, and it wasn't even good. In my opinion, guys, Elden Ring, once again, one of those games, overhyped, not really good. To me, all it was the same old Dark Souls game, rebranded to open world. And, you know, of course, I've said it a million times, the gaming community has this boner for open world. So you put a Souls-like game and open world together, smash it.
A vast open world game featuring a map five times the size of the previous game. Oh boy, I can't wait. It's time to explore!
Ooh, a stick and $2. What a discovery. Open world games are truly amazing.
For this to be the game of the year, we're not doing too good. I can't really comment on the VR game of the year, but Hitman 3, it makes sense. I mean, being able to play Hitman VR makes total sense. Now, this is where we start to get insane. 2022 Labor of Love, Cyberpunk 2077. Now, their argument is that, you know, they've been good parents so far. Well, if you've been a good parent so far, this goes to parenting as good as the parents being cracked out drug addicts when your child is born, because Cyberpunk goes down as one of the worst game openings in the world. It's one of the first games that's ever been taken off the marketplace. They did refunds forever. And quite frankly, guys, I bought it when it first came out. I returned it. I didn't buy it again.
Oh. Is this game worth it? Eh. Does that answer your question?
And I probably won't. We really need to get past this shit, guys, where we allow this stuff to go on. The fact that, like, this can even win an award and people are praising this game. Guys, a game should come out at least working, okay?
What's the most important aspect about any fucking game? Well, being able to fucking play it.
That's just my opinion. Better with friends, Raft. I mean, cool. Anything that kind of resembles Minecraft is going to probably do good. Outstanding visual style. Spider-Man Miles Morales. Didn't play this game. Played the first one. Can't comment on what it looks like. Most innovative gameplay. Now, come on. If you guys have played Stray, listen, I knew this was going to be a top tier game just because it's a cat and the internet loves cats, but you really play the game, it's not unlike a lot of other games, except for the fact that you're a cat, okay? Portal's another one of these games with more of an original idea. Is this innovative gameplay? I mean, it's not innovative because all it is you're the main character is a cat. The gameplay really isn't different. You jump, you move around, you do this because you're a cat. But is that a gameplay element? I mean, not really. Like, it's a pretty ambiguous title here. Fresh perspective and brain-breaking surprises. Oh boy. Best game you suck at, Elden Ring. I mean, yeah. Makes sense. Best soundtrack, Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy always has some good soundtracks. Outstanding story, rich game. God of War. Makes sense. This probably should have won Game of the Year. Not gonna lie. Also, the outstanding visual style probably could have won too. This game really swept the floor in terms of games this year. Sucks to see that it's not really getting the recognition it deserves. Sit back and relax, Lego Star Wars. I mean, okay, are the main people on Steam 10 years old? And then Death Standing Director's Cut. So we have a walking sim as one of the best games. I mean, guys, this is an absolute. Basically, what I'm trying to say is let's forget about 2022. Let's hope 2023 is a better year, because this award ceremony and the games that won, Jesus, I could think of Nintendo games that would smash all these games out of the park.
Humbug!
For all of this, it's just, it's been a bad year, boys, but we're gonna recover. We have to, or it's hasta la vista for the gaming industry as a whole.